Dear students, in previous lecture, we discussed about design of stator slots and you have seen what are the factors to be considered for choice of number of stator slots, what are typical values of stator slot pitch. Okay, now let us discuss design of stator winding. And in case of design of stator winding, you will be studying how number of stator turns are determined, then cross-sectional area of conductor, then how armature windings or stator windings are decided. Okay. Then what is the procedure to find out stator turns per phase? Okay. The stator turns per phase TS can be estimated from stator voltage, stator phase voltage, and maximum flux in the core. Okay. And the maximum flux in the core can be estimated from specific magnetic loading and main dimensions of machine by knowing main dimensions of machine like D and L and number of poles. Okay, already we have discussed what is specific magnetic loading. Okay, specific magnetic loading B average is given by P phi divided by pi DL. Okay, and from this equation P phi is equal to B average pi DL. Okay, then from this flux per pole phi equal to B average pi dl divided by P. Okay, as tau equal to pi d by P, flux per pole phi equal to B average tau l. Okay, here maximum flux is estimated by knowing all these parameters like B average, D, L and P. So from this equation you understand flux to obtain flux per pole phi, specific magnetic loading, then as tau is pi d by p, then diameter of machine should be known and number of poles are to be known, then length of the axial length of the machine. Okay, and once flux per pole is obtained, then stator voltage per phase ES is given by 4.44 f phi ts into kws, where ts is number of stator turns per phase and kws is stator winding factor. The stator winding factor is product of pitch factor and distribution factor, and usually for full pitch winding pitch factor is 1 and for 60 degree spread winding factor is 0.955. therefore kws is product of pitch factor and winding factor, and distribution, for distribution winding with full pitch coils kw is equal to 0.955. okay, then from this equation stator turns per phase TS is calculated as TS equal to ES divided by 4.44 f phi into kws. okay, this is the equation for calculating stator turns per phase. But in case of synchronous machine, depending upon number of parallel paths per phase, okay, this equation gets modified as ES equal to 4.44 f phi kws and TS divided by A, and A is parallel paths per phase. Okay, so from this TS equal to ES into A divided by 4.44 f phi kws. You try to understand difference between these two. Here number of parallel paths are not considered, but here by considering number of parallel paths, A number of parallel paths, TS can be calculated using this equation. Okay, then what is the procedure to find out cross-sectional area of conductor in case of stator winding? And to find out area of each conductor, stator current as well as current density in the stator conductor should be known. Okay, the area of cross-section of stator conductors can be estimated from knowledge of current density, kVA rating of machine and stator phase voltage. Current in each conductor IZ equal to, it is also taken as equal to per phase, IZ equal to IPH, which is equal to Q is kVA rating, kVA into 10 to the power of 3 divided by 3 ES. So you know a kVA, Q is expressed at Q equal to 3 times ES into IZ. Okay, so from that equation here current in each conductor is written as IZ equal to Q divided by 3 ES. ES is nothing but stator phase voltage. But if there are A parallel paths, then conductor current is IZ equal to, here IZ equal to IPH. Taking A number of parallel paths, IZ equal to IPH divided by A. Then area of each conductor is given as AS equal to IS divided by del S. You know, current density is current per area of conductor. Therefore, current area of each conductor AS equal to IS divided by del S, where del S is current density in the stator conductors. And for normally cooled machine, the permissible current density in the stator conductor is assumed to be 3 to 5 ampere per mm square. So this is the procedure to calculate area of cross section area of stator conductors. Okay, then coming to armature winding coils and their insulation. See, usually in case of silent pole machine, the stator winding is employed using two types of coil, right? One is single turn coil, another is multi turn coil. See, in case of single turn coil, or in which case single turn coil is preferred, that single turn bar winding is used in machines when the stator current per circuit exceeds 1500 ampere. For large capacity machines, whenever depending upon output rating of machine, when current is very high, then single turn bar coil or multi turn coils are used. Okay, and on account of large current, the conductor cross sectional is also very large accordingly. Okay, and in case of bar windings, the conductors are subdivided into many parts. Purpose of subdividing that bar winding is to reduce eddy current loss in the winding. Okay, and subdivision is achieved by laying a number of bare copper strips flat wise in the slot. Okay, I will show the schematic diagram of this afterwards. And in case of bar winding, there will be two conductors in each and every slot. Okay, and each conductor consists of two vertical stacks of copper conductors, and they are usually insulated with either treated asbestos or gloss rovings. Okay, so this schematic diagram shows how arrangement of winding is done in case of single turn coil within a slot. Okay, this is a slot insulation, and strand insulation is required, and between vertically arranged stacks, separator is put. Okay, this is a separator, right? And this is the main insulation, right? Here, in case of bar winding, two conductors are put in the slot. Okay, two conductors are put in the slot, but they are subdivided into many parts just to reduce eddy current loss in the machine. Okay, and each and every vertical stack, there will be two vertical stacks, and two vertical stacks of copper conductors are insulated with asbestos or gloss rovings. Okay, so here you will clearly understand how single turn bar coils are put, and usually width of slot is 25 mm and thickness of main slot insulation. This shows thickness of main insulation, and thickness of main insulation is usually 5 mm, and this thickness depends upon voltage. Here main insulation and its thickness depends upon voltage. Usually for voltage rating up to 10 kV, thickness of insulation is, main insulation is 3.6 mm. For 11 kV, it will be 3.8 mm. And for 16 kV, it will be 5.1 mm. And for 18 kV, usually it is 5.6 mm. As voltage of machine increase, thickness of main insulation should be increased, because dielectric strength depends upon thickness of insulation. Okay, then coming to multi-turn coil. The multi-turn coils are usually machine wound. Okay, and in addition to insulation between individual strands, insulation between turns has to be provided. Okay, in case of single turn coil, there will be strand insulation, right? But in case of multi-turn coil along with strand insulation, inter-turn insulation is also required. Okay, and in addition to this inter-turn insulation, whatever inter-turn insulation is used, its thickness is decided by taking over voltage during surges, and that inter-turn insulation should be designed to withstand surges of magnitude 1.5 times the line voltage with a duration of few microseconds. Okay, here whatever thickness is decided, or dielectric strength of that dielectric depending upon voltage rating is decided. If machine is designed to operate at 11 kV, then whatever insulation or that thickness of insulation is decided, it should withstand at least 1.5 times the line voltage. 1.5 times that 11 kV should be withstand voltage withstand rating of that particular tar insulation provided. Okay, and then inter-tar insulation used is usually mica tape and half overlap and asbestos. Okay, this schematic shows cross section of multi-turn coil, how arrangement of conductors are done, and how many types of insulation, strand insulations as well as inter-turn insulations along with separators are put. Okay, this image shows in case of single turn coil how arrangement of bar will be placed, and usually in case of single turn coil two conductors are placed. This is first layer conductor and this is second layer conductor. Within one slot two conductors will be put. Okay, one conductor will be at the top, another will be at the bottom. Okay, this is first layer conductor and this is second layer conductor, right? See, this is enlarged view of stator winding when single turn bar coils are used for synchronous hydro generators. Okay, then this image shows complete stator winding, right, using bar conductors. Okay, here this portion is overhang. Okay, this is the overhang, and within slot bar type of conductor sizes, and as I said, when current exceeds 1500 ampere per circuit, usually bar type of conductors are used. Cross sectional conductors are not suitable for such winding because current density is very high, right?